taking care of your health, making sure you feel successful in your life.
Hi, my name is Ray Goris, and this is part of the Dowland service to provide basic information about how to properly take care of your health.
Taking care of your health basically is a method of making sure you feel successful in your life for many people, because being successful in your life helps you to boost your confidence, and your confidence helps you to continue with doing what you think is good. What Taoism does, it tries to help you develop ideas and thoughts and methods to make sure that you gradually develop the right kind of functioning in your life. And there's three different factors which determine, according to Taoism, your success. Three different factors are being summarized as number one, two, and three. The first one, and that's probably the most important one, is that you have to know yourself. Currently, by most people, knowing yourself is being explained as understanding what is the turmoil within you. So we have a lot of psychotherapy to figure out all the details of your interior. And in Taoism, this is being described as trying to count corners in a house, in a room. And if you start counting, you all the time start noticing new corners. So you're never really finished. So if you go look at what you already have from start, this is basically counting corners. What Taoism wants you to do is it wants you to reconstruct yourself and build a personality and a cosmology that depends on that building to create a knowable you. This is basically what it is. So you want to change yourself from a random, fragmented and accidental self to a knowable self. And the whole process of exercise, meditation, ritual, and so forth and so forth, these are tools to help you build that self. That trajectory starts with just calming your mind. And from calming your mind, in the advanced meditations behind that is the construction of a personality that is suitable to you. And the Chinese Taoist philosophy with the Wuxing, Yin Yang, and so forth and so forth. And one is discipline. I'm not talking about the military discipline that people talk about in Wudang per se, because I'm of course a Wudang Pai person. They talk a lot about military discipline because they associate with the military, they associate with the government, and so forth and so forth. But this is not necessarily what is meant. Discipline means having a plan, and it means you have to know where you want to go to, and you need to know what you have to do to get there. And then you have to also act. So discipline is planning and acting. And what is advised for that usually is what is called the Tai Chi policy. Tai Chi policy is the method that Taoists use to deal with things. That means they all the time, they move, go through things, they guide, they don't really make any decisions, they don't do anything. Then the third one, last but not least, is you have to know the world. That means you have to read, you have to watch videos, you have to talk with people, you have to communicate, you have to study, you have to read into science, you have to read into Chinese medicine, you have to read into Taoist philosophy, you have to do all kinds of things, you have to be busy all the time acquiring information. Living means acquiring information. You only have to look at your children to understand that what I'm saying is right. And because children, what they do is they all the time look for information, and all the time they look at more and more information. And as a parent, it is important that you teach your children to look widely and not only at a limited amount of space. Like when you go to school, the school wants you to only learn mathematics, only learn language, and so forth and so forth. And as a parent, you have to make sure that they also learn all the other things, like what food is there in the environment, how do I deal with the climate, how do I deal with my health, and so forth and so forth. That all these things are being managed, that they learn how to move properly so that they don't get sick from wrong movements. They don't get weak as a result of wrong movement. And for moving properly, you have to move a lot. So you shouldn't let people be quiet, children be quiet and sit on the sofa. And for you also, yourself, you have to make sure that you're wild enough, that you move a lot and you do a lot of things to make sure that you are lively enough to become curious again. You say, the process of evolution. In the beginning, all our developments were random, right? Everybody, I guess, can agree with it, that we were not very systematic in our thinking and feeling, and we were accidentally finding things out, and things got saved from generation to generation, or they were reinvented every generation again for a while, and gradually we became more systemized and organized until in this time we have so many disciplines in our daily life that it doesn't make sense to be a random person as most people are. That's the whole thing. When you don't communicate properly, you walk into barriers and people become impatient. And then the communication breaks down because your own fragmentary organization frustrates other people's fragmentary organization. And then you get all these post hoc decisions about what you actually said to be able to agree with each other. That's actually philosophical, isn't it?
Did you get it?